Hi, it's Jeff.
And Denise from MouseSteps.com.
And this is Mouse Steps Weekly, episode 17.
Sponsored by Theme Park Connection in Winter Garden, Florida.
And Maple Leaf Tickets in Kissimmee, Florida, our official ticket agency.
And on this day that we were in the Magic Kingdom, I think that was a rain day too, just like right now.
The theme of this last week is rain. The hurricane Isaac is kind of going by right now. And here's a look into Fantasyland.
An entrance into Fantasyland. I think that's pretty exciting to be able to see where you'll be able to walk
in. Yeah, I mean, you can see how huge this new enchanted forest will be. But that was the coaster, the Seven Dwarfs
Mine Train. And there's Sir Mickey's and Snow White's, formerly the Scary Adventures.
Right. They are changing that to a princess meet and greet. Hopefully good.
Do not
despair. It could be okay.
I don't think it'll be as good as the ride.
Another view of that new entranceway. It looks very...
We were lucky that day because look how cloudy it was. And it must have started pouring. We've been dodging a lot of rain showers lately.
Dodging a lot of rain.
And there's the castle.
Beast Castle.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and right through the turrets. I thought that was a nice shot you did.
That was kind of neat. And you spotted this. Well, we kind of both spotted this, didn't we?
The Be Our Guest. Well, I was like, oh, we should get some pictures. And it's like, oh, look, there's a sign for the Be Our Guest restaurant.
And we had just the day before got our reservations for opening day. So we're so excited.
November 19th is opening day, from what I understand. Oh, and look, there's like a griffin. I think that's what it is behind it.
Gryffindor? No,
not a wrong park.
Gotcha. But there's also that neat stained glass. I mean, it looks like it'll be nicely themed.
It looks beautiful. And I just wish there was the menu with prices, because we know the menu, just not the prices yet.
I like that. You know, the menu has things like leek soup, which doesn't sound like it's a good idea when you're having soup. What?
Well, even during lunch is a casual, just for anyone who doesn't know, it's a casual service restaurant, and then at night it's table service.
There's Mr. Gaston.
And now he's in front of some lamps.
His tavern, perhaps. Maybe he's in front of his
tavern. No, I mean there's lights in front of him now. You can see beautifully lit lights all through Fantasyland now.
And we figured out what you thought was snow and what I thought was the sea.
I actually thought it was ice.
Right. But why would there be ice anyway?
I have no idea.
But it turns out it is a place to plant this nice foliage. And I'm not sure if that's real. I think it is probably synthetic grass.
Well, I'm sure it's synthetic. I mean, they can't really go up and water it so easily.
Oh, and there's the tracks. You never see the tracks, but that is the roller coaster tracks inside the show building, which will probably be almost enclosed by the next time we get to the kingdom.
I think so, too.
Because this was taken last week.
And there's a look again. You're looking towards Pinocchio's village house. And
I like how they go along with the Pinocchio architecture. You know,
it looks
pretty
good, right? And there's I think
snow-capped. This truly is snow-capped, perhaps. Yes.
And excuse my voice. I have a sinus infection.
You sound very good.
Thank you.
Very fine.
I don't think I sound good.
Now this is the former Skyway station area.
Right, and it looks like some very exciting bathrooms going in.
Well, I don't know if that's a bathroom.
Restrooms, because I've been corrected.
Very futuristic to me.
It looks like the wonders of life is going in with the sign.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, what have you heard?
Supposed to be a Tangled Tower, probably not a meet and greet, or as I'd call it, a pee and greet. Supposedly it's supposed to be on the hill,
so it's hard to know. Her hands are
going. It's supposed to be like on the hill, supposedly, so who knows.
But I would be all set for a Tangled Tower. Maybe they saved the one that they had at the Flower and Garden?
There's the back area,
side of
the backside.
Yeah, I guess that wouldn't make sense what I just said.
I think that would be very nice. I think Rapunzel...
Christmas lights.
Unlike Merida, Merida's popular, but Rapunzel and the Tangled is so popular still, even a couple, is it 2 years, a year or two since the film came out?
Yeah, and they're clearly doing work on the Yankee Trader as well, obviously.
Obviously. Oh, and we're already at the Disney's Grand Floridian Resort, also about, I think it was raining while we were there.
Yes, quite literally, we were in the rain. It was actually raining while we were taking this shot, but we were undercover, luckily.
And there's a water activity area, and we had mentioned last time that it would be Alice in Wonderland themed, and you can really see it now with the Mad Hatter hat and the teapot and cups. And the beach pool bar behind it is going to take the place of Gasparilla Grill and Games. It might have already. I don't know if because of the rain, if it has changed.
Do we know if that's
schedule.
A permanent thing or just temporarily while they're working on the Gasparilla?
I thought it was supposed to be out there probably for the guests over at the villas, but I'm not positive.
So I'm thinking both perhaps will be in operation when they redo the
It's possible,
gasparilla.
And you can see, I don't know if we just saw the
Well, we're about to see the, I think this is the soda area inside the little building. So that's ready to go. You can go get your soda pops while you're enjoying the pool. Right there. So
although it wouldn't be,
a good be
much
thing.
Fun out in the rain, having like today, you wouldn't want to be like, oh, let's go get
it's
some
inside.
Quick service.
No. It's sort of
if you're going from the main building.
Oh, right. Well, maybe they'll
further.
Have a covering.
No, I don't think so.
They'll have yeah.
But the water play area looks very nice.
So yeah, so we will keep checking in every couple weeks and see how that goes. Also, when we went to the Magic Kingdom last Tuesday. We enjoyed the Country Bear, the original Country Bear Jamboree, before it's going down for its lengthy rehab.
And there's rumors, even that Big Al could be gone, but I don't know that would happen.
I think, this is just me thinking, it'll be a tightening up, sort of like at the Tiki, or the Enchanted
That's
Tiki Room in California,
than
where they just tighten it up, take away some slow parts. But to me, I mean, I love the original show. I know there's a lot of... non-PC elements to it, but it's still funny.
I actually don't like the song Blood on the Saddle that much, but I don't want Big Al gone, and I don't want them to change anything. So.
And it's not really the first time there's been changes to the Country Bears, because there was three shows. Mm-hmm. There was the Vacation Hoedown and the Christmas show. So
I never saw Vacation Hoedown.
Well, you're about to, because this week's vintage segment is some stuff that my family shot back in 90 or 91, maybe, yeah, 91. And there's Henry with his Camp Grizzly t-shirt that still fits, kinda.
And there's all the bears, just as you would normally see them, but a little different.
Right, this is the exact same segment that we just saw from the very last show of the current Country Bears. This is the same segment, but from the Vacation Hoedown. So it's the end where everybody comes out and they all do their thing.
Apparently they're going swimming.
Yes. Well, it's summertime. They're on vacation. It's the Vacation Hoedown. See how they're all the sunbonnet trio are in their bathing suits?
I'm going to have to watch this, because I don't think I ever saw it.
I will show you the full show. I have multiple versions
of, course you
of
do.
The full show. But yeah. So it's really cool. It's always different to see the bears doing different.
I like
type of
the
thing.
Christmas show, and I miss the Christmas show that they used to have every year. I think it's what 5 or 6 years since they've
had it. It's been a
it?
While. It's definitely been a while. Oh, there are my favorites, the heads, I call them, and there's Wendell Quickly, who went by him in his Elvis attire, but.
I see Henry is still the ringmaster and. Has his, again, the Camp Grizzly t-shirt.
And here oh. is, no, that wasn't, that's Henry, but that's Wendell that was just about to take a picture. He takes your picture, and they say, no flash pictures. That includes you, Wendell. You'll see from the show. And I'm talking into Star Wars Celebration 6.
And this was a lot of fun. I only got to go to one day because my dad was being honored in Washington, D.C., and so I flew out there. So this is a very good, I like how you... It got the shot going up.
Well, I was trying to capture what you would see if you went to Star Wars Celebration 6. And we had a lot of fun. You were there for the first day.
I was there for one day.
So we had quite a bit of fun just walking around. Oh!
I am so disappointed that I missed him this year, because we saw him 2 years ago, and he is the funniest job.
And he has an accompaniment today.
Right? He didn't
he
have...
He has his slave. His
he
slave
didn't have
Leia.
A slave last time.
Yes.
And he sings go-go songs.
Right, he sure does. So you'll definitely go to the show notes to see this, and we've also linked to the first time that we were with him.
And there are some stormtroopers.
Yes, some assorted stormtroopers.
And we have one with a Mickey bar later.
Yes. This is the Disney booth on the show floor, and they were doing land office business. See, he's waving his cash.
It was a little disappointing this time around. They didn't have pins and... You know, it was certainly scaled down from the first time, the first time around.
I guess the hot ticket this time was the Vinylmation.
Right, the Princess Leia hologram Vinylmation.
Yeah, that was probably the...
And it sold out Friday, right? Or Saturday?
Yeah, it sold... No? Yeah, I think so. Yeah, it sold out Friday night, because I didn't see it there Saturday. And there it is. That's what we're talking about. And they also had this other cool die-cast set of the original Starspeeders. And it's heavy, and it's smaller than it looks, so We picked up one of those too in my collection. And they had the
carbon freeze. Mm-hmm. We've never done that.
No, it's very expensive. It is probably why we haven't done it.
But it's personalized, so it's been very. I think it's been very popular.
Yeah, I would not be against it. Okay, and here's the panel we both went to.
Right, the collector panel, and that included Casey Jones and I think you call him Quinn Kimball.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And this is just different items like the Muppets.
And that Rizzo was debuted.
Yes.
And here's a few sneak peeks.
And I'm actually pretty excited about the die-cast cars. But
yes, but there is Admiral Ackbar. It's a trap!
And that's a Vinylmation. Obviously, they're showing the Vinylmation ones right now.
Right, and they're the large-size Vinylmation. Like, there's the Jabba.
Jabba the Hutt. But I wonder if he sings Vacation.
I suspect no. But here's, go ahead, you can tell. This is what we were talking about earlier.
Right, this is like Mater as Darth Vader.
Right.
Which, I guess because it rhymes, they did it. And there's Lightning McQueen as
Luke Skywalker.
Right. And Princess Leia as
Sally. And Luigi as C-3PO and R2-D2. What's the name of the little guy? Do you remember?
Guido.
Yes, Guido.
I think.
There's a tractor as a stormtrooper. I think they are very cool.
Right, and they were handing out little collector cards for them. Oh.
And here's the wedding. Now, that is the Mr. Chewbacca himself right over
Peter Mayhew
to the right. And Elvis is officiating. This is the kind of fun thing that you see at the Star Wars events.
Elvis, but as a stormtrooper.
And I asked, and they had said it was a real wedding. So I can't guarantee that to be true, but and of course, more Leias.
Right.
Everywhere you go.
They keep getting chained to the Jabba the Hutt.
Well, they're slave Leias. It's a slave Leia. So now we'll take a look around the convention. It is a giant AT-AT from The Empire Strikes Back. And here's some merchandise. I think you took these pictures.
The Talking Admiral Ackbar plush. There was quite a few items, and I
Gamorrean guard.
I'm always worried when I use that word. I don't know if I.
This is the best item they had. Well, this was not. This is not for sale, by the way.
Jeff,
this is
a one of a kind.
One of a kind. So you weren't here for this, but this was the premiere of the Clone Wars season 5, and this is behind me. There's Seth Green, Dee Bradley Baker, a lot of the voice talent. So it was really neat to be sitting there getting ready to record this and hear all these voices, and then I look over and Dave Filoni, the director, was right next to us. So it was. Very fortunate.
You were in the front row, I think, yeah, right?
Very, so worked out nice, and it was a great presentation. And so back to the show floor, more Leias, of course.
They're everywhere.
Yes.
You can find Leias.
But this
everywhere.
Is your favorite.
I
thing.
Love that. It's like a stroller with a baby in R2-D2.
And the mother was remote control driving it around. And there is another mashup with the Batman, Joker, and of course, Beaker.
I love that. And this is so cool. It's Stormtrooper with the Mickey Mouse bar.
Just like the ad. And here's old school Epcot dressed Mickey. That's not an official Mickey, by the way.
No.
Now, you were not there Saturday for the Star Tours presentation.
Panel.
But so I'll kind of walk you through it.
And Jason Sorrell wasn't there this time,
He was at the convention, but
right,
not
we
for
saw
this.
Him.
And those are the actual vehicles. What this is sort of is the story matrix, all the different versions you can have of the new attraction. This was a concept art of how you were going to go over a cliff and fall into the water, but I think that's been overdone,
right.
And they realize that too. This actress has been in every one of the safety briefings of all the different Star Tours. I think that was pretty cool.
I don't know if I knew that.
Yeah, I didn't know that either.
I don't think I did.
And now they're talking about the guard who checks the luggage, and it's always funny because he'll be talking to you and he'll miss certain things. And I didn't even know about this one, but this is very cool. It's a Madame Leota is being shown.
And I don't think we saw that. We were in the queue for a couple
of
hours.
It seems odd that we never noticed some of these.
How would you not notice
it? A great presentation.
We
have seen that one, but we haven't seen the Jar Jar in Carbonite, so we'll have to look for him while we're in the queue next time. And here's another little hidden thing. There's Han Solo. So if you actually watch the movie, Han's back there. And a hidden Mickey in that particular segment. I think that's a Coruscant.
A lot of little cool things.
Originally,
details.
There was going to have water. You would crash and water would come into the vehicle, but they thought maintenance would have been an issue with that. So it was
That's very interesting.
So that was it. We're going to wrap it up.
Yeah, I just wanted to mention some of the merchandise that we saw from the collector's panel will not be until next year. Some of it this year, some of it next year.
Keep an eye out.
Diecast vehicles.
It's another show.
Thanks. Sponsored by Theme Park Connection.
Maple Leaf Tickets. And we'll see you next week with a special show.